What you manifest in your mind, you can bring to reality.
Welcome to a new episode of the Ultimate Movie Championship, where I and Keith go to flickchart.com and we build our ultimate movie list. Let's get it going with this episode right now.
Now, if you're just listening to this, we
our
played
last episode.
Yeah, on our last episode where we talked about 10 Cloverfield Lane. Ray introduced me to this game on flickchart.com.
Yup.
And it's Versus, and it's where we they give us two movies, and we pick which one we like the best.
Yeah, and if we haven't seen it, goes to our list of shame. Over time, it'll compile our top 20 list.
And
our
I
top
have not seen the Barefoot
list.
Mailman.
You haven't? Oh my! That's a 1951 classic, Keith. I am surprised that we haven't seen that
with
one
old
yet.
Robert Cummings.
Although I haven't seen The Day After Tomorrow either.
I have.
We're gonna have to just, I guess. Oops! I guess they have a button for that. Have you seen American Pie 2?
Yeah.
Okay. So American Pie 2 versus The Mask.
The Mask.
The Mask, 100%.
100%.
That would have been horrible if there was a tough decision between something and American Pie 2. All right, so we got Beauty and the Beast animated 1991 versus Home Alone a year earlier.
Home
Cole
Alone
Culkin,
for me.
Holiday classic. Agreed. I love that movie.
It's a John Hughes, right?
Sure. No.
No?
I don't know. It might be. I don't really know.
Oh, here's
Kill
your,
Bill 2 versus Die Hard.
Versus
the
Christmas
first
classic.
Well, this Die one's going to be easy for me. If it was Kill Bill 1, maybe I'd have. Although I do like 2. I don't know. That should just be Kill Bill, I guess, as a whole.
It's, yeah. But I wish they would just call it one movie.
Yeah. I mean, we get it. We watch long shit. But yeah, Die Hard.
You think you're going Die Hard?
Yeah. Are you not going Die Hard? I mean, I love Kill Bill, but Die Hard, like I said, it's like, it's for action movies. Well, first off, a holiday action movie.
Christmas movie.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if it takes place during Christmas time. And there is
it's
holiday
a Christmas
music.
Party.
Yeah, I know. But shit gets real, son.
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker. All right, yeah. I'll give it to that. That was... We'll go Die Hard. Cause
just for... I mean...
It was one of the first of that genre.
Legacy. Whatever. I don't know.
It's spawned 26 mediocre movies.
Yeah, well, that one... I like the third one. I don't know. Yeah, it fell off. I don't think I watched the other ones. Anyway, so we got The Deer Hunter versus Star Wars Episode 3. Now this is the one, I don't know if we want to count this one since I know I watched the beginning of it and I woke up towards the end of Star Wars Episode 3. I saw the no and then the flippy flips. So between the two, 100% The Deer Hunter.
I've got to go with The Deer Hunter. Beat him out!
That's an intense movie, man.
Fuck yeah, man. Are we slapping the shit out of him and shit?
God damn it.
Ugh.
It's very tough. It's a tough one.
Making him play fucking Russian roulette.
I think I've probably only seen that movie once.
It's hard.
And that's all.
It's a hard watch.
Wow, this, I appreciate the fuck.
Haven't seen Ice Station Zebra.
God damn it, me either. So The Sixth Sense versus...
Versus Loading.
Castaway versus The Sixth Sense.
Good. I mean... These are pretty even.
Oh, man. For me, I'd go with The Sixth Sense. I'm not a big fan of Shyamalan. I mean, his last movie was pretty good. I'll
agree on that. Castaway, it's kind of a one-and-done movie for me.
Yeah.
Like, it was good, but it's so slow. And then
like,
I mean...
Tom Hanks is a G.
And
he's
then I
so
don't,
good.
And then I don't want to get all teary-eyed over a goddamn volleyball, so I don't want to watch it again.
Yeah, it's like, why do I care?
Why do I care about that goddamn volleyball?
Clear product placement. They use the product's name.
Isn't...
Yeah. So, Sixth Sense.
My name's Voight, asshole.
Yeah. No, no. You're Wilson now. Kunta Kinte. All right. That's the volleyball roots. Where he's trying to change his name. You are Voight. No!
Wilson. I am Wilson. All
right. Weird Science versus Hook. Man... I'm a fan of Hook. A lot of people don't like Hook. Maybe not a lot of people, but it's surprising what the fuck just happened.
Well, that was weird.
Okay, so, never mind. It was Hook versus that, but something happened.
I kind of wanted to... That was a good one, too.
Was it Hook versus...
It was Weird Science. Let's
weird
do
science.
It anyway.
Yeah, we can do it anyway.
We're rolling it.
Yeah, yeah.
Hook versus Weird Science.
Yeah.
I don't mind Hook. Like, yeah. I watched it as a kid.
Yeah, yeah.
I liked it.
Yeah.
It's shot really well. Fucking,
I mean, it's a kids movie.
The Lost Boys.
Yeah, yeah. There's a really weird, awkward. And it was awkward when I watched it as a kid. Well, maybe not as a kid.
It's weirder now.
Oh, for sure. When they first, when Peter Pan first starts doing the Never food with them, and the chubby kid says, "You're doing it, Peter.
You're doing it.
It's just like, it's the most awkward. You don't really want a kid to be saying you're doing it to an adult like that, even though it is Peter Pan and he's playing along with it. It was just really the execution on that. I'd like a different read. I'd like a different read from the kid. It's almost like if that kid was in the same bunker as fucking John Goodman, it's just they'd awkward the fuck out. Because he would be, like, awkward to the kid, but the kid would be, like, equally awkward back.
I liked the part where Rufio and Peter were trading disses. Mm. And it was just the most ridiculous things they would say.
You're a green, green, and do goon cood.
Yeah.
It's like, well, those aren't words. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was, I liked that
but,
as a kid. I enjoyed it.
Weird Science.
Weird Science.
Fucking classic movie.
Yeah.
Spawned its own TV show, which ran for like 3 seasons.
I don't think I ever saw that.
It was on USA. You wouldn't
nope.
have got to see it. But I fucking love that movie. Is that another Hughes movie?
I don't know, but you could just keep saying it.
They all see it. I'm just going to say any of those.
Like it. Just because it was made in the 80s or
any of those
90s,
movies are all John Hughes movies.
I don't
movies.
Think it was, but I'm going to guess no. But we should have a separate screen up for IMDb and shit.
For John Hughes watch?
Yeah. It'll just be the drinking
so
game
what,
every
what are
you time
going
you
with?
Think. Between the
Kelly
two,
LeBrock.
Here's the thing.
Oh, man, they made
here's
a girl.
I didn't own Weird Science growing up, so I didn't see it very often. I watched it a few times at friends' houses, but
wearing
I did
their
have
bras
Hook.
On their head.
I did have Hook, so I grew up with Hook. So that nostalgically means more. But, you know, I don't know, man. I mean, I'd go with Hook. That would be my thing. But... You know, I'm not...
Luckily, we can't vote on this one, so we can agree to disagree. Yeah, we can.
If it comes up again,
we'll fight that
we'll
motherfucker
bring
to the death.
Shit back up. Okay, so we got the Lion King versus the first Spider-Man.
The first Spider-Man. This,
oh, this
is the first Tobey Maguire.
Super easy.
And I'm gonna go Lion King.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. Hakuna Matata. All right, so we got Oh Brother, Where Art Thou versus The Terminal. Have you seen both of these?
Yes, I have. And
this
one's
a super easy one for me too.
I mean, Terminal, while well acted and
I think
everything,
that's a
is
Spielberg movie.
It's fucking slow as fuck balls.
And it's another movie where it's just
like
Tom
nothing,
Hanks acting,
yeah, just against nothing. Pretty much, like I'm stuck in a terminal. I'm stuck
Brother,
on an
where
island.
That was I. First off, I was working at the theater.
I
so
like the soundtrack to it.
I loved it. The scenes like when they first go up and sing that I'd always be at the sound thing to turn and listen to that song, and then at the end of the movie, there's good songs. Yeah, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? And it's a really fun movie too.
It's a really fun movie. Well shot,
and
fucking,
it's a crazy movie.
It
like
is
the flood. It's like, yeah, there's. It's just like it's. I love it. Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Okay. Sorry, Terminal.
Terminal, not a bad movie. Just
yeah,
slow.
But that shouldn't be anywhere on our top list. So Napoleon Dynamite versus Wall-E. I mean,
I gotta say Napoleon Dynamite for what it was worth.
Yeah.
Even
Although I really liked WALL-E.
Even though WALL-E, I guaranteed, holds up way better.
And it's a really good, like, story. It's like, we're fucking ruining the planet, and we're all gonna turn into
fucking
lazy
movie
fucking
with, like,
assholes.
No dialogue at all.
Which is amazing that it's not boring
like
as fuck.
Like an hour and 45 minutes.
They're like, oh yeah? Oh yeah, Tom Cruise? We're not even gonna talk. How about that?
Tom Hanks.
You too. Fuck you. Fuck them both.
Fuck you both. Hey, anyone named Tom.
Tom Hardy? Respect, bro. But we're... Wally. All right.
Eva.
I still say Napoleon Dynamite
for sure. Because there are parts at the end, even though I get it, the slobby people, it's just like... Anyway. There's... It's... yeah, I like
I'm that. Quoting Napoleon Dynamite a whole lot more.
Oh, for sure.
For I mean, obvious
just way
reasons.
More things. I don't think I've seen this one.
Harry Potter and the Half-Prince. I have not seen
Prince.
It.
Yeah, I don't know if I've... I may have, but I don't know if I have.
But this is Donnie Darko going up against... Oh,
Ace
this is a hard
Ventura,
one.
Pet Detective, this is super easy for me.
For you,
I mean, although Donnie Darko is a complex movie and it's well-made...
Independent movie.
Pretty much the only good movie this director has been able to do. He's like had flop.
Yeah,
after
he really
flop.
Has.
Although I didn't mind some of them. Like, I don't remember what the one was. It was like 08 or 09 it came out. But
I think he did Domino.
It's like kind of a post-apocalyptic. No, he didn't. He may have written it, but that was like Ridley Scott or something like that.
Really?
Yeah, or his brother Tony Scott. I think it's Tony Scott.
For real?
Yeah, there's two directors. Right. Well, one's dead now.
You're just going...
I think Tony Scott died.
Ridley Scott's still alive.
Ridley,
he just did
yeah.
The Martian.
Okay, yeah. So Tony Scott. He did, like... Tony Scott did...
It's weird.
He did a lot of, like,
names.
Crazy editing. I think he did that one Man on Fire, which is an awesome
Denzel
movie.
Washington.
Denzel Washington, yeah. He has a really...
It's a really good movie.
He had a really stylistic editing style in all of his movies. And it was like... He shot things completely different.
If I remember, Man on Fire had a lot of weird, like, out of focus shots for seconds.
It was a lot
like
of flash cuts,
yeah.
And like the subtitles were stylized, kind of.
The lighting would alter at some
yeah.
Point.
It was like, yeah, it was highly stylized. But anyway, I don't know how we got there. Donnie Darko, although being
I
a
have
great
a tattoo,
movie, I get that. So it's I see where you're leaning, but Ace Ventura. I mean, classic comedy. Jim Carrey, one of. I mean, he's so good in so many movies, but that was like.
I love how the camera keeps going in and out.
Yeah, I changed something, and then it's like only on the close shot that it fucks up. It's just because there's things that usually show up on the bottom, and it cycles through.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going through a playlist of like 10 shots that are exactly the same shot. I added in this frame that has that little QR code thingy on the bottom. In between, they cycle, and it's just I forgot to change the camera angle.
Oh, all right.
So there's that explained.
For
those watching the video,
yeah.
That's why it's doing that. I'm trying to get a closer
shot
on the TV.
It had distracted me a few times.
We first started the show, I was like, oh, no.
I didn't know.
That's why,
like,
I moved it to the wider screen and then just one of those things.
I'm willing to be swayed. I mean, while Donnie Darko is a great movie for me,
yeah.
It's...
And what kind of tattoo are you going to get from Ace Ventura? I mean, really. You're going to get way more... You're going to get better tattoo ideas from Donnie Darko
yes.
than Ace Ventura.
But
as a movie... So we're going Ace Ventura?
I'm going to break on this one I loved Ace Ventura as a kid. Like,
it's
I can't deny
bad,
it was a...
Yeah.
Hell, I'm a Dolphins fan. Dan Marino's in that shit.
Okay.
Laces out, Dan.
And we both have hemorrhoids. Not as bad as...
as Einhorn's?
Einhorn, yeah.
Einhorn is Finkel.
Finkel is Einhorn. Yeah. All right. Pirates of the Caribbean, The Curse of the Black Pearl. Versus Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas.
Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas by 10,000%.
Two movies.
Johnny Depp
Johnny
in it
Depp,
out.
Yeah, where he's basically the same character, except for just more fucking...
Yeah, one he's Hunter S. Thompson, the other one he's fucking Keith Richards. It's fine.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay, so Fear and Loathing, for sure, between those two.
He's doing, like, just two real people.
Jesus, Sleeping Beauty, the 1959. Animated. I didn't know it was that long ago. The Walt Disney animated classic versus Stand By Me.
And Stand By Me wins by a fucking landslide.
Stand By Me.
Kudos to you, fucking Stephen King.
Kudos. And Snickers bars. Avatar, the
no one's seen Mater of the
it's Ghost a sequel Light? To a Cars movie.
Some one of those side
how did that sneak
video?
In here? Jeez. Alright. So Mars Attacks versus Avatar. Man, I really want to watch Mars Attacks again because I wasn't ready for it when it happened. I couldn't appreciate it. I didn't understand I was going in to watch a high budget B movie as a kid watching that. And when I was watching it, the Abitap? Fire alarm was pulled. Abitap. Well, that's the. I don't know
language,
where that
but,
is.
You know, when you were watching Abitap, how did you feel?
I mean, Abitap. Although the story not being original, but the just it was beautiful.
The visuals,
it was amazing.
Yeah,
I
mean,
so it's like,
you gotta,
I would have to
go
with
Abitap
over
AKA
Mars,
Avatar.
Mars Attacks. Yeah.
Abitap.
So,
I
although
love that name.
Out of the two, I really would rather watch
Mars
Attacks.
I would rather watch Mars Attacks instead of Abitap.
Yeah. All right. So, Abitap. Sorry, Mars Attacks. So, Ocean's 12 versus Star Wars Episode 1.
The
Phantom Menace.
Fucking Ocean's 12, 1,000%.
I'm good with that, man.
Dude, I don't play with that prequel shit. All right, bruh.
I'm glad. I thought you were just going to go based on Star Wars alone. So we got Life of Pi. Did you ever see that?
Nope.
All right, it's a good movie.
Austin
Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me, which is the first one, which I watched because somebody downloaded it, and this is in the day of Napster. It's because they used the school's internet and it was way faster. So that was one of the first movies that everybody had a copy of in high school. So Life of Pi is gone. Austin Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me versus E.T. the Extraterrestrial.
E.T.
I mean, yeah, it's got to go E.T. Sorry, Austin Powers, even though your history has been noted. The Truman Show versus...
Still guilty of not seeing The Usual Suspects.
Why is that coming up? You would think they would remember that. Oh, am I logged in? Yes, I do. Okay, so Men in Black 2 versus The Truman Show.
Truman Show.
Truman Show. Even though there is a talking pug in Men in Black 2.
Yes, there is.
Didn't make it, and I didn't have a pug then. Out Cold, 2001. I want to say I've seen that.
I know I've seen that. It's
Spider-Man 3. I've seen parts of that.
If we're got to go, Out Cold has one of the London brothers.
I don't know who that is.
He would have been Pink in Dazed and Confused or the one from Mallrats.
The one from Mallrats?
There's two brothers, Jason and Jeremy London.
Okay.
They're twin brothers. They both act.
Okay.
Some, one's in some shit, one's in the other. It's one of those in Out Cold as the lead.
Right.
And it's about it.
Man, I don't know with this one. I really don't give a fuck with this, actually.
It's the one where they do the prank of they get their drunk buddy into the car, and then they start spinning it around in a circle on the ice.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they all start screaming.
I'm sure I'd remember shit when I saw it, but it was forgettable when I saw it. Because I probably saw it.
It's a comedy. It's fun.
Back
it's like
when it came out.
It's kind of an homage to the old ski comedies from the 80s and shit.
Which I totally related to growing up in the desert.
I'd been skiing a couple times, so whatever. I say Out Cold Spider-Man 3 was garbage.
So you're going Out Cold?
Out Cold.
Fucking, I'm totally good with that. So Batman... The 89 Batman.
89,
was that
Michael Keaton, Tim Burton
versus
Batman.
Pulp Fiction.
Pulp Fiction by a landslide. Yeah. Even though...
It's a sad matchup to have.
Batman was a good movie for then.
Yeah. Yeah. It was a...
Haven't seen...
Decent one.
Claire.
I have not either. So, sorry, Claire. Hopefully you don't come back. Tom Hanks Big... Versus Star Trek, the remake, the first JJ.
Oh, yeah, Chris Pine, Zachary Quinto.
Which is the action-packed Star Trek.
It's the Star Wars track.
Yeah, that's why they're like, hey, you turned Star Trek into an amazing Star Wars movie. Why don't you come over and make a Star Wars movie?
Because someone fucked up the last three, George.
Yeah.
Fucking looking at you.
We bought them for you,
George.
JJ.
Fucking.
Thank you, Abrams.
Frog monster. I gotta go with big.
Yeah.
By far.
Just gotta go with big.
Is that another John Hughes movie?
I'd really like to know who it is, but I know it's not, man. All right.
Fucking. Do you like two more?
Yeah.
Or saving not. Your choice.
Okay. So The Departed versus The Patriot.
Easy this one for me.
Departed.
Departed.
The Patriot was a good movie, though. Aim small, miss small. Aim small, miss small.
All right. The Patriot, The Postman, the fucking whatever. All those fucking movies came out right around the same time.
Mm-hmm. That one was good, though. I don't think I saw The Postman. All right. So the last one we'll do Ratatouille versus Bruce.
Haven't seen Ratatouille.
No Ratatouille. I think we fucking dismissed that one before too. Come on, website. Fuck. Haven't you like updated since? So
Bruce Almighty. I've seen the Chamber of. I don't know if that's the first one.
2002. I don't know either, but I know I've seen it.
I've seen the Chamber of Secrets.
Versus Bruce Almighty.
I would have to go Bruce Almighty just because I'm not really.
Yeah.
I mean,
I did like the first. I was with the Harry Potter series for most of it, and then like I just kind of fell off.
I guess I shouldn't say like I never gave it really a fair shake. I probably watched the first four, and I was sick like one day, and they were just like playing a marathon or something. I was like, whatever, I'm fucking Harry Potter it up.
Bruce Almighty's
hilarious. I mean, it's a cool world. Yeah. Bruce Almighty's got a lot of really good funny parts, and Morgan Freeman's God, and Morgan Freeman loves to smoke weed,
and
so that just makes me think God smokes weed.
Sure. There you go. He invented it. Why not?
Terrible sequel with Steve Carell.
Yeah. Yeah, I hated that. It's just enough with the religious shit. But it was Bruce Almighty was fun.
He did that. Yeah, that was the Noah's Ark weird one.
Yeah. All right. So that was it.
Thank you for watching this episode. New episodes of The Ray Taylor Show come out every single day. Subscribe on IGTV, YouTube, and everywhere else podcasts are found. Go buy my artwork over at inspireddisorder.com and save 25% when you use coupon code INSPIRED. Follow me on social media @RayTaylor. Have a wonderful day, everybody. Peace out.